This is a basic tutorial video to show how I convert my channel videos to 3D using the depth map feature in DaVinci Resolve Studio 18.5 Video Editor. Let's start with opening the Project Manager and starting a new project. Next, go to bottom right setup window and select your frame rate, in this case 30. Then go and set timeline resolution to 3840 by 1080. Click Save. Go to Edit Screen and drag in your 4K 3840 by 2160 video and then drop it into the video timeline to do your editing. Switch to Fusion window. Now let's bring in the nodes to set up our 3D project. First, let's copy our media in node since we will need two of them. Click on the copied node and then go pick the image plane 3D node from the 3D tools section. It should automatically connect. Select the left side small dot by clicking on it to see it in the left viewer. Now highlight media in one node and then go up to the effects tools section and click on open FX and search for depth map tool and click on it to load it in. Now let's display it on left side viewer and let's view the image plane on the right viewer. Click on the image plane and then go search for Display 3D in Tools section. Click it and it should load in. Now make a connection from Depth Map node to the Display 3D node. Now we can view the extruded view based on the depth map. Let's go to the controls and dial the scale down to 0.06. With Display 3D highlighted, go to the 3D Tools section and pick up a 3D camera. It should also bring in a Merge 3D node, as you can see. After making some adjustments, go to the control panel and make the following adjustments to the 3D camera controls. Adjust clip far setting to 2 and uncheck adaptive clip select angle of view type to horizontal. Now we need the render nodes. Click Merge 3D 1 node, then go to 3D Tools and select Render 3D. Go to Render Controls and set the camera to Camera 3D 1 and pick Left Eye, then change the render type to Hardware Render. Go to Image tab and uncheck Auto Resolution. Now we need a Right Eye Render 3D node. That means we copy the left one and change its setting for the right eye. Now we need a combiner node to combine these two render nodes into one side-by-side file. Let's make some final adjustments. Go to Image Plane 3D Control Settings and change Subdivision Settings to 300. Then go to Depth Map Node and make the following adjustments. Make sure the quality setting is on better. Faster would work, but video would be jittery at times and it is distracting. Check Adjust Map Levels and make the following adjustments. Feel free to experiment with these settings to get better results. The idea is to improve the grayscale of the depth map. We want closer objects to be white and far object to be darker. Check isolation checkbox and make some adjustments. Do the same for post-processing. Keep the blur slider level close to the middle, which makes the depth map blurry, but that takes the sharp edges off of our subjects and makes them blend in with their surroundings. Drag the blue vector arrow until both views match. Now go to the camera control panel and move the eye separation slider to 0.25. You should see two cameras separate. Make some more fine adjustments. Let's save our project and then go to render page. Pick a folder and a name for your video and then change the following settings. For video format, pick MP4 or QuickTimes and choose H.265 for codec. Pick an encoder. I use native. You don't have to use these settings, but based on my experience with this software, these perform the best, at least on my machine. Make sure to change the output resolution to 7680 by 2160 for best results. Make sure the entire timeline is selected and press Add to the Render Queue button. Then press Render All. The video should render in 2 or 3 hours based on the size and frame rate of your video. When the render is complete, you should be able to upload the file to your VR headset and watch it.